It was sunset, and I was driving back to Kansas from California when I first saw Salt Air, an abandoned amusement park located at the end of a long causeway out into the Great Salt Lake. The lake had receded, and the pavilion with its strange Moorish towers stood silhouetted against the red sky. I felt I had been transported into a different time and dimension. I stopped the car and walked out to the pavilion. The hair stood up on the back of my neck. The stark white of the salt beach and the dark quiet of the deserted buildings created the weirdest location I had ever seen. When I got back to Kansas, I discussed Salt Air with my friend, co-worker, and writer John Clifford. We agreed with the Salt Air location and others we had scouted locally, we could develop a script for a very eerie feature film. Well, John wrote the script for Carnival of Souls in 3 weeks, and our crew spent a week in Salt Lake City filming Salt Air and 2 weeks in Lawrence, Kansas filming the rest of the movie. We were naive enough to hope for the look of a Bergman film and the feel of a Cocteau. When a preview of Carnival of Souls was shown in Lawrence in the fall of 1961, the audience's reaction was mixed. The Bergman look and the Cocteau feel were a little too far out for the time and place. That year, Carnival of Souls was shown in shortened form, primarily in the South and drive-ins as part of a double bill, and then it went underground. Making the film had been exciting. Distributing the film had been agonizing. So we bowed our heads and returned to other filmmaking activities. But Carnival of Souls had affected more people during its short run than we thought. Through magazines, books, and television, it has become a cult classic. Now, 28 years later, Carnival of Souls has been restored to its original edited form and has appeared in many film festivals and theaters all over North America. The motion picture you're about to see on this cassette is the only authorized, restored, and complete version of Carnival of Souls as it appeared in its theatrical run of 1989 and 90. You know, you have to be careful about making a weird show or watching a weird show. It may come back to haunt you. Enjoy.